guys, I welcome you on your favorite show, Life in Abuja. Yes, today, as you can see, I'm in Yerikaswa Market in Gwarimpa. And today we will be looking at the increase in the cost of goods and services. In goods, I mean food items. Food items have been on the high side for some time now, and the common, you know, Nigerian man has been complaining due to the increase in food items. So we'll be looking at how, you know, market sellers are able to go to the market, you know, the challenges they have to go through, cost of transportation, increase in goods, and how they are able to, you know, overcome this and still make profit despite the increase in foods and services. So guys, hear from these vendors themselves, their experiences, and you know how they overcome it, how they make their profit, and how customers react to the increase in cost of food items. I remain your host, Lady Masiara, and this is MyRadio TV. See you.
My name is Felicia Christopher. We go market yesterday where we Karimo market. This beast we are buying. Nah, they said that before 900, but I buy 1,000 yesterday. They know we better move. They take the set up. We go for Gary. Gary, we they buy more like 20,000. We buy 25 a bag. If you say any nothing way, go say I cheap for market. If you want, we where would they sell it? They worry us. And even the, for the shape, where we they nah, then they increase everything. How's where first today? Then they increase up everything he had. So come quarry with me. So they say cost, but not me cost. Not me cost. I'm not going to go by like this fish where I go by for fish market. Then tantam, that 30 where I buy them, now so the money be. If you sell a free, no good gain if you take up. May government help us to need something because of poor people. I beg.
I am by name Abigail Shin. I am a marketer. I sell golden penny oil, power oil, and kings. I sell Maggi, not chicken, and not beef. I sell Reku. Before I used to buy it 950 naira per single, but now I'm buying it 1,100, which is cost now. The challenges there I face is that by then, I used to buy things much, but now I can't buy it much because it is cost. And the commodities too in the market, they are not like before. They are scarce now.
My name is Hassan. Nasel, this one na foreign 1,000. This one Nigeria, 800. This one na local rice 700. This na sell. This one small beef. Na sell 850. This one na sell 900. Corn na sell 450. And soya beans na sell 600. Before I sell this one rice foreign, I sell 400. Now na sell 1,000. This one na two rice. Before na sell 350. Now na sell 700.
It's Muhammad Inua Gambo. I'm selling green tomatoes, tatashi, as well as onions. This kind of business, it don't have specific price. It can decrease today. And also it can increase. Why? Because it depends how we get the place where we are buying. For instance, as today I bought this green, a bunch 1,000. Yesterday I bought it 700.
So guys, here we are right now at Kadobiko Market in First Avenue. We've actually been to the Tipa Garage Market where we get to hear from these market sellers their challenges, how, you know, the cost and the cost of transportation is affecting their market, you know, how they're having issues with customers, how customers are finding it difficult, you know, to adjust to the new, you know, prices. And they're saying that it's not been easy for them because a lot of them have to experience, you know, market getting burnt and all that, and they have to start afresh.
I sell foodstuff, provision and frozen food. But currently, I don't have any in my counter because of the fire outbreak in the market. So I'm just trying to pick up. Then sometimes, especially all this foodstuff that we are selling, there is a great increase in the price of things. Like this beans, we normally buy noodle, $2.50, $3.50. But currently, the price for this honey beans is $9.50. And if we come to the market, we'll be selling 1,000 naira. Coupled with our cost of transportation, buying of leather, and how long it will take before we finish selling it. So probably we are not making any gain. We are just using it to maintain customers. Some of them, if they come, they will tell you that the price is higher, that they are going to tackle, that the price is cheaper there, which I don't think is so. Because no one will buy beans for the price of 950 and still sell it for that same amount. So we are just using 50 naira to sell. Sometimes some of them will go out because of the price. Some will be rude to us. So it has not been easy for us. Because before, when things were normal, within a couple of weeks or 1 month that you stay in this foodstuff business, you make a great savings. Then, when shop have not burned, I used to pay contribution of 5,000 naira every day. So if the government should, any measure that they can put on to reduce kidnapping, raping, because young girls go to farm, and all these other things, and even the reduction in the price of petroleum, we also contribute in the reduction of price of things. Because once the price of petroleum is high, the cost of transportation will affect the goods, the price of goods.
My name is Grace. Before they buy rice, 20,000. Mana I don't cost, they sell on 35. In them they sell on 2,000. Before they buy for their aunt, 2,000. Mana is 3,200. Nigeria rice is 50 before. Mana is 26, they sell this now. Even spaghetti. Before a carton is 2,000, mana is 4,200 they buy it. They complain, they very complain. Every day they complain. Because the thing is too cost. And then they buy it like before again. Market no they move. My hungry day anyway.
So guys, it's all about, you know, the increase in price of goods. You can hear from each and every one of them. It's not been an easy one. Stay with us as we always keep you guys updated. And until we see again next time, this is Smile Radio TV. Do not forget to follow us on all our social media handles on Facebook, Instagram. Okay? Please like, you know, give us a thumb up. And until we see again next time, I remain your host, Lady Messiara. Bye for now.